が最高峰を待ち続け。
Hello, today we're talking about the very first hands-on with Street Fighter V. I'm joined by Wes, who has had his hands on that very game.
My grubby hands.
Yeah. What did you think of it?
It's good. Mm-hmm. It's good. Perhaps not as excited to play Street Fighter V for the first time as I was to play Street Fighter IV for the first time back in 2008.
Okay.
But then I think the sort of shift between Street Fighter III, Third Strike, and Street Fighter IV was incredibly pronounced. Whereas the sort of shift this time between the latest version of Street Fighter 4, and there's only just been a new version of Street Fighter 4.
Visually there's a lot of comparison there, right?
Street Fighter 5 looks pretty similar to Street Fighter 4. So it's coming out on PC and PS4, and will run in 1080p resolution, 60 frames a second.
What's wrong with that, by the way? Did you get to talk to them about any of the cross-platform stuff?
We only know that there will be cross-platform play between the PC and PS4 version, and they promise, the very best, latest version of their proprietary netcode sort of system.
That does sound incredible. This is the first major fighting game to have managed something like this, right?
Yeah, well, it's not like a shooter where you have the whole sort of keyboard, mouse versus gamepad argument. Playing a fighting game, most people will play a fighting game on a PC using a peripheral just like they do on a console. So theoretically, there's no advantage for either player.
The one hurdle there is that netcode is going to have to be superb.
Yes, and they've had netcode problems in the past.
Yeah.
So there's a bit of pressure there, I think, on them to really nail it with this. A lot of people are playing it online, so they really do need to get it right.
All right, cool. Well, let's switch over to the gameplay itself.
Yes.
What changes can we expect there?
I think Street Fighter V is a little slower than Street Fighter 4.
Okay.
So the tone, it's not something I think sort of casual observers will notice immediately, but I think people are obviously familiar with Street Fighter 4, play it a lot, will notice that it's been slowed down ever so slightly. But perhaps more importantly, they've made fundamental changes to some of the character movement speeds. So, for example, M. Bison now is completely different. You're going to have to sort of think about how you're going to play him completely differently, because his on-the-ground movement, just sort of moving left and right, is incredibly slow.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he walks with his arms crossed,
which is, I like that.
Very M. Bison.
Yeah, like,
he's
really
the dictator,
is.
He's the grumpy villain of the story, such as it is. From a gameplay perspective, he's incredibly slow. And at first, it's really difficult to sort of get to grips with him because he's so slow. But, he has great options now in the air. Like, he can do a sort of down forward dash attack from the air that's really fast and is really easy to catch your opponent out. So while they've sort of like rebalanced him quite significantly, and you would perhaps consider him to have been sort of nerfed, he does have options elsewhere that sort of make up the difference. So M. Bison is definitely very, very different.
I imagine when talking about game speed, it's hard to make a verdict at this stage as to whether or not that's good or bad for the series.
Yeah.
It's just different, right?
And we have this every time. The game speed from Street Fighter has changed over the years with all the different versions. Mm-hmm. And players sort of just, they get used to it, and in the end, things settle down. It's really hard at this stage to see if the sort of slightly slower speed has a negative impact on the game. Personally, I don't think it will. It'll probably make it a little bit more accessible to more people.
Sure.
But I still think the sort of similar sort of skills are very transferable. So
cool. And then outside of game speed, what else are we looking at?
Yeah, so the focus attack from Street Fighter 4, which I loved, I think a lot of people ended up loving it, has been completely ditched. So they've taken that out from the game and they've replaced it with what's called a V-trigger.
Just to quickly jump in here, V-trigger, the V stands for what there?
Victory, very important player.
Or is it
five.
Just five? It's five, isn't it? Okay. Right.
You now have a V-gauge, which you fill up through the process of playing a match. When it's full, you can use hard kick and hard punch to trigger your V-trigger. V-trigger is different for every character, so it's like a powerful, unique action. Ryu, for example, his V-trigger powers him up so that all his moves do extra damage. He's got a few different moves, Basically, properties change. But it's different for everyone. Elsewhere, every character's got a V-skill, Now this is medium punch, medium kick, which is the same input command from focus attacks.
Right.
So I was playing Street Fighter V, and just because sort of I've got that sort of muscle memory of place
yeah,
doing
that
the focus
really
attack,
nice.
I found myself doing the V skill instead of doing the focus attack.
Oh, okay.
Just because
right.
my
see,
brain
yeah,
is
sure.
like make like I was just doing it in certain senses. But you get used to it. Now V skills you don't need any meter for, and they're more like utility moves. And again, different for every character. Now, what's interesting is Ryu's V skill is a parry. You know, everyone remembers the famous Daigo versus Justin Wong match when Daigo parried every single attack from Justin Wong's Chun-Li for a really dramatic comeback.
Is that sort of possible?
So
again?
Yeah, it's sort of possible.
Right,
yeah,
cool.
But for Ryu, and it's a really cool thing to do because it's different. You know, it's not something that really was in Street Fighter 4. And then every character has a V reversal. Now, V reversals are like the alpha counters from the Street Fighter Alpha series, which is basically if you time it right, you can counter your opponent's attack and get a hit in.
Sure.
So it's interesting. It's like so focus attack has been ditched, but you've got more options now, I think, even though focus attack, you know, is lovely and everyone loved it.
Fair enough. Okay, here's a question. This is obviously going on your first impressions here, but is that enough? Does the game feel different enough?
I think that Street Fighter V feels perhaps a little too similar to Street Fighter 4
okay.
than I was expecting. Now, like, I remember playing Street Fighter 4 sort of in 2008 in a Japanese arcade before it even came out in the West. And the sort of shift from what had gone before was so pronounced. It was such an incredibly exciting moment to play that game for the first
yeah,
time.
You kind of want that again, don't you?
That's what I want from Street Fighter V, and I'm currently not getting that sort of like that buzz.
Mm-hmm.
It's not quite there. I think
it's not that you dislike exchanging.
Like,
it's just
this will be a fantastic fighting game. Like Capcom makes fantastic fighting games, the best fighting games I think, and Street Fighter V will be a brilliant fighting game. But I think that the impact it will have will be sort of less pronounced as Street Fighter IV's. Right now, I'm not getting it from it.
Okay, fair enough. Well, one thing you may have noticed while listening to this video is that my Street Fighter knowledge isn't comparable to yours, Wes. My analysis isn't going to be anywhere close. However, I have managed to pick apart some of the gameplay that we're looking at right now. In particular, the London Station level, which is new to Street Fighter V.
That is new.
I thought there's some interesting things to spot here. They really give a sense of, you know, how Street Fighter views British
what
train
Japan
stations.
Japan thinks of London.
Yeah. So first of all, there's a telephone box slap bang in the middle of the station, which, as you know, that's a common occurrence.
Yeah, I think we've got loads of those in East Croydon Station.
It's a real problem, actually. They often get in the way, to be honest. There's a guy holding a croquet stick. I often do that myself.
Our national sport.
Yep. A steam train, the preferred mode of transport in the UK.
Well, yeah, again, you know, that's one of the reasons why the trains are always late.
Some of it's just a bit weird when you look at it from a different perspective. Like the Palace Guardsmen, with the bearskin hats and everything, forming a brass band whilst there's a fight going on that they should potentially be
most of those guys do fight, you know, to defend crown and country.
Yeah.
But those particular ones are from Yorkshire, so their brass band is all they really know how to do.
It's a bit odd. Punk rockers, nice. And also I like that the fight takes place next to the iconic building from London Station called London Pub. A favourite haunt of mine, actually.
Yeah, well, you know, it's a chain, you know. The London Pub chain of pubs is you know, there's one in Croydon, there's one in Brighton. I think there's a few between Croydon and Brighton. So, you know, given that they've all seen them every time they come here,
it's that attention to detail that really, you know, kind of separates this game. And as you said, Capcom are, you know, head and shoulders above some of their competitors. And this is why.
Well, finally, we'll be able to play Street Fighter V in what looks like our backyard.
Okay, so it's a bit odd, but I actually really like that level.
It's
really cool.
If you think about Street Fighter down the years, it's actually been like it's built upon cultural stereotypes.
Yeah, absolutely.
Every single arena in the game is basically what I think of this country, like based on the book I just got from Waterstones.
Yeah.
And you know, so it's in keeping. It's
brilliant.
Just funny.
I think it's great.
It's just funny. The bowler hat guy is my favorite.
Oh god, yeah.
He's just doing nothing.
Yeah. Well, okay, cool. Well, that's our first look at Street Fighter V, and I assume we'll see some more of it at E3, that would make sense.
I'd pay attention to Sony's press conference. I think we'll see it there.
And yeah, cool. Well, thanks for that, Wes.
Cheers.
Hello and welcome to the Eurogamer show.
What are you doing here?
Well, I can do links.
No, you can't.
Coming up this week, LEGO Worlds. Is it worth leaving Minecraft for?
And Ian's playing a game called...